Respectfully, you might want to do this. First of all, if you notice on the servers button, there is a plus sign that you can click and you can create your own local host server. From here, you'll be able to pick one of many maps that you have available. For today's example, I'm going to look at Dust Bowl. Let's pull it up because I think it's got some good examples of what the Skybox is and help explain some of the things that you can hit when you're rocket jumping or trying to navigate around in a map. So once you're inside the map, because you did do a local host server, you can use the server command. So we're going to use the server command cheat, and this will enable us to no clip. And now no clipping will take away anything that your player model or player can bump into. And this will also allow you to fly. You see things like tires on top of roofs. Mission begins in 60 seconds. After the setup time, it does pull you back and you do have to enter the command again. So let's take a look at skyboxes. Now you will see how at the edge of this map it goes from very detailed to very less detailed. This is where the skybox is, and you'll see over in the distance when we break through, that is the skybox that is being rendered. And if you stand in the right place, once we're in the skybox, you'll see how it kind of echoes into the distance, and you'll see a repeated version of it. Well, that's not a good example. Let's get a good example. The rocket and the smokestack here. So you see it's identical, it is exactly what you are seeing in the sky, and if we go back to where the map actually is, you'll see where the rocket and the smokestack is. So it's a way of having map makers have extra detail that you don't actually get to see. So let me go to a better place. Let's see, over here is a good example where a sniper, let's say you're sniping up here, and you can see off to the distance on the right, the distance is actually the skybox. So it's a way for map makers to make the map look a lot larger than what it is, and before Half-Life 2, the maps didn't have this. You also see that I don't actually render the next section of the map here until I pass some sort of invisible wall. Even though that building there that you should be able to see should be there, for the sake of the number of pixels you have to render and stuff like that, it helps speed up the map. It's a couple of tricks that map makers use in order to make things run smoothly, I guess is the best way to say it. You don't want to stress out video cards by having a map that's too large. Speaking of large maps, this map, like many of the multi-section maps, are actually fully rendered. All the sections of the map are here, and it waits for different triggered events to do with the capture points before it unlocks different sections. So let's go all the way through to the end. Just flying around. Okay, so here's the rocket ship and the smokestack. We've seen you guys before. It's a trick. It's an optical illusion in order to make this rocket and make this sky look bigger than what it is, but right at this point here it cuts off and you can actually see things through the skybox object. Very weird, very tricky, very useful too, because if anyone's played the old Team Fortress or the old type of maps, stuff like this didn't happen. The older Counter-Strikes didn't have it. So let's go to Demo Man, and I'll take him back to the same spot just so we can play around with and have a look at what exactly is happening here. So we know that it's cut off right there, and if I jump up to it, bam, I hit a roof, I hit a ceiling. I cannot go higher than that object. And even though my stickies can go up where that cart is, I am not allowed to get up there, even though that is still lower than where the skybox is. Why is that so? It's because there's a player clipping wall, an invisible wall that you don't get to see, even though I can get directly under it here. There's an invisible wall that I'm not allowed to clip through. The map maker has put it there. and we'll explain why mapmakers put it there in just a moment. But there are objects within the clipping range that you can get on, like this bull's head here. Even though there's no real advantage to doing it, you know, I could shoot over here, but I can already shoot over there from being down in this position here. So, no advantage. It just happens to be there, and there are a couple objects like that around the map. The more you play around in the map, the more you'll find them. But let's rocket jump up here. Bam, I hit the roof somewhere underneath this light, but if I charge up a shot and I shoot it really high, you'll see it bump off of something up there. What did it bump off? Let's go here and let's no clip up to it and see. So you see, if I go up, you see the background's gone all black. Let's go on down until the skybox actually appears. Bam, this is the top of the map. Now the reason they don't want to let you get this high is if you look around, especially over where the rocket ship is, everything looks distorted, everything looks weird. This is bad. This is bad for the map maker to let you see these. So instead they put a plane right around here that you're not allowed to go over. And so long as you stay underneath here, everything looks okay. It's the same reason you can't get on this roof here. It's the same reason one particular team can't get through that wall, or that you can't get through this wall over here as the attacking team. There's an event that'll make that garage door look like it goes up. There's an event that makes this fence look like it disappears, and they will remove an invisible wall that stops you getting through here. Same with these gates. There's an event that it'll count down. Those gates will go up. They'll actually go up and into the wall. So there are some objects that you can clip into, some objects that you can't. The reason the map makers do it is so that you don't get to see some of the smoke and mirrors that go into making the map. It's all for looks. They're not trying to intentionally tick you off. So yeah, go ahead and play around. You'll learn a lot about how a map is and the things that you can do on a map if you come into noclip and just mess around in it for a little while. Feel like Superman going around. And this is where I'll leave off. I'm not going to be able to win this game because even though I have my person on the final capture point, this is not the capture point that's currently triggered. So, thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.